a video. I did a video on foreign films, foreign language films. In a way, this is a companion piece, but not really. It's not soundtracks to those movies. I just wanted to, you know, we're a small world here, and we're a big world, and there's a lot of shit going on in the world. We gotta love one another, get together. Come on, everybody, smile on your brother. As the Youngbloods sang the Chet Powers song. I want to showcase some foreign language records. A little segment of English-speaking bands and artists that recorded in other languages, basically posers that did it to penetrate the market. Maybe I'll start with those. Not that they're not serious, they're fun in a way. And then I'm going to go with just some of my favorite foreign language artists. Now, there are a lot of artists that have sung partial things. For instance, Leonard Cohen, being French-Canadian, has some bits of songs in French. And there are plenty of others. That's just one example. There's going to be so many that I leave out that you're going to come up with. And that's fine, because these things aren't definitive. They're in the moment, what we want to say. So Mazzy's foreign language. I love listening to music. And unfortunately, I know some Spanish, but I'm not bilingual. And I'm not fluent in any other language but English. And some would argue that in even English, I'm not very fluent. While we're playing, it's one of several Los Lobos Spanish records. Great LA band from East LA. I love Los Lobos. If the world ever gets back on track again, you ever get a chance to see Los Lobos, they're almost like seeing the Grateful Dead. Not sound-wise, they're actually better musicians in a way, and better songs. But they go on these jams and they do covers. They do a great version. Last time I saw them at the Fillmore in San Francisco, did a version of Tomorrow Never Knows, the Beatles song. So they do plenty of covers as well as their own things in English, Spanish, acoustic sets, as well as electric sets. And they're just so diverse and wonderful. And Los Lobos is one of my favorite bands. And they're not spoken about much here on the vinyl community or anywhere around here, but they're great. So you got to see them some point. There's another Spanish album I'll pull up here, but Los Lobos. So first, let me show you the posers. You know what that means. I mean, that's just me being snarky. I got a small poser pile. I could have probably researched and looked for more, but these are over the top of my head. Dean Martin, okay? A twofer that came out at Collector's Choice Music years ago. My buddy Vernon worked for them, so I got all these promos, all of his reprisier stuff. And this has French style, these are twofers. French style album and Dino Latino. And it's not all in Spanish or French, but of course he sings, you know, like Volare. Actually, Volare is not on here. Ça c'est bon. But I love Dean Martin, Dean Martin fan. You wouldn't consider him a foreign language artist by any stretch of the imagination, but I'm showing Dean Martin because I fucking love Dean Martin. Now, Swedes who sing in English, who do Spanish. A fantastic record, Oro. Oro en Español. Comprende Español. Oro, it means gold. Gold, like gold hits. I used to have the vinyl version of this, and if anyone has a copy and wants to send me VCLT, I'll gladly accept it because I don't have a copy anymore. But this is sort of the ABBA's greatest hits sung by Swedes in Spanish, and it's fucking fantastic. Fernando. What's Spanish for Fernando? Let me think. It's Fernando. Chiquita. Chiquitita. Gracias por la música. Gracias por la música. Thank you for the music. And on and on and on. Dame, dame, dame. Mamma mia. Mamma mia en español. ¿Qué en español? Y es mamma mia. Anyway, it's great. I mean, you know, phonetically they sang these songs. It's fucking awesome. I love this record. One of my favorites. Two singles I got. I think these are on some album comps. But David Bowie singing Heroes in German. Helden, excuse me, German. And in France, in Francais, Heroes. So these are two import singles. Let's see. French single and I think a German single. Anyway, of course, French and German. What a concept. Bowie, poser. But he lived in Berlin. Let's give the guy a break. He's international. He's so fucking cool. Cooler than, you know. So David Bowie singing Heroes. And that's one of those songs that is a universal song. So it should be so sung in any language. The best singer ever in Genesis was Peter Gabriel, and he did several of his albums sung in German. So this is Melt, and this is whatever the fuck they call this album, but in Deutsch. So in Deutsch. So kann ich even helfen, was ist das? Geschlafen mit Schlag. I don't know anything. I know a little Yiddish from my grandmother, but these entire albums are sung in German by Peter Gabriel. Cool records. I just love hearing that. You know the records? Dankeschön. Oh, Dankeschön. I should have bought Dankeschön by Dankeschön. You know, what's the Vegas guy? And of course, there's always got to be a Beatle connection. If any of you have seen, you got to watch the movie. One of the best movies of last year is Jojo Rabbit. And one of the opening sequence, or just almost the opening sequence, they use Come Give Me Thine Hand, which the Beatles doing. The Beatles singing I Want to Hold Your Hand in German. They did two different songs. I'm sure all you Beatle freaks know it. The Beatle freaks know it. Maybe you other amateur Beatle collectors don't know it. But Come Give Me Thine Hand and Sib Lib Dich. They did She Loves You and I Want to Hold Your Hand, German overdub versions. I believe, and I could be wrong here, they did the overdubs while they were in Paris for... Sorry, there was a little dissolve effect there because I got sidetracked. Phone call came in. When you're using your phone, it shuts out the video. You don't even know that. But the Beatles picked up a lot. John and Paul, and especially John, picked up a lot of German all those days and nights and playing in Hamburg. So they used to... you know, John did his German gibberish as well as his regular German to a point. And those are great versions. This is a rarities album that came out in the early 80s, late 70s, early 80s, that had a lot of other stuff. It's on the Past Masters in the mono and stereo box, I think. Yeah, it is. Of course it is. But and it's also, Come Give Me Thine Hand is on the American version of Something New, American album. So those are the posers. Now let's get the real stuff. I'll start with just three CDs. And I want to show mostly vinyl, but I had to put in Sugaro, Icelandic band. I don't have any of their albums on vinyl. I love them. Obviously, they sing in Icelandic, but great band, and their music just works better. I can't imagine. I guess they sang some English stuff, but I just love their moody, moody sound. I don't even know what the fuck you call this record, but one of my photographers did a project in Iceland and brought this back to me early on, or whenever this album came out. I have no idea the date. And I can't even talk about the band. I like them when I hear them. I know they've been on a lot of soundtracks and TV shows. They're amazing. They're wonderful. I don't know much about them historically or technically, but I know I need to get more of their work or get their work on vinyl. A favorite of mine, Sheila Chandra. Sheila Chandra is English and Indian and a great, amazing voice. Does a lot of sounds with her voice, like noises like, which isn't really a separate language, but these are on Real World, which was Peter Gabriel's international label, Real World. And these are fantastic records. I don't have any in vinyl. Some of her earlier stuff before this is very out there, avant-garde stuff. Another Real World favorite of mine is, I showed this on the VC before, Jeffrey Oriyama, who's from Uganda. Beautiful folk album. I have two of his records on compact disc, only this one on vinyl. I think this is the only Real World album that came out on vinyl. Beautiful folky African record. He just passed away last year, I believe. Great record. This was one of the best records of last year. It's been on the VC by several people. This is Amajar, and very kind of cool, folky record. But I don't know what to say about this, but highly recommend it. I am a fan. I have most of his work on CD, only a couple on vinyl. Ali Farka Touré, an amazing guitar player. These are produced by Nick Gold. Beautiful records. World Circuit Records, and great guitar player. Again, love this stuff. This is a comp. This is a cool comp that just came out again. So if you like sort of Japanese pop disco-y stuff, which is kind of fun, you have to be in the mood for it, but it's Pacific Breeze, Japanese City Pop, 1976 to 1986. It's on Light in the Attic. It just was reissued because it's been going out of print every time they print these, press these up. But it's a cool record in the last year and a half, I'd say. But all Japanese pop. I think I showed this one of my favorites of last year. Gabby Moreno, this is with Van Dyke Parks, but this is half Spanish, half English. Includes the Ry Cooder, Jim Dickinson, John Hyatt song Borderline. That's in Spanish and English with Jackson Brown. She sings in both languages. It's a gorgeous, beautiful record. African Scream Contest, I've showed these multiple times. Two of my favorite albums of the last several years. Hard to get out of print, two volumes. This is sounds, psychedelic Afro sounds from the 70s and African sounds 70s from the 63 to 1980. Both volumes are great. If you can find these, grab them because you don't see them. The great label Analog Africa. I have other things on Analog Africa. I try to buy anything that comes out now on Analog Africa, but you have to pretty much find it in Bandcamp. Remember that time at Bandcamp? Probably one of the most profitable records that came out in this country is Buena Vista Social Club. Cuban music, great Cuban artist, put together, arranged, basically produced, well, produced by Ry Cooder. You know me and Ry Cooder, we're like, I'm a fan. Great documentary on this, making of this album and the further tour when they came to Carnegie Hall. There's a live version by Wim Wenders, great film. There's been a series of things I have on CD. I'm only gonna show the one on vinyl I have, Offshoot, and this is Omara Portundo. Omara Portundo, Buena Vista Social Club presents. There's a series on Nonsuch that came out, or actually, this is World Circuit again, but some of them came out on Nonsuch, a few other labels. Ibrahim Ferreira was also one of the singers in Buena Vista, that I have a couple of his albums. There have been a few of the artists from Buena Vista that went on to do solo projects, but a gorgeous, gorgeous record. Here's another CD interlude of an artist that I fell in love with in the 90s and early 2000s and have almost all of her CDs is Cesaria Evora. These are amazingly beautiful folky pop albums, gorgeous records, and I highly recommend any of her records. You should pick out, this is the wrong one, but these are great. Maybe this is one to get. I mean, you can get any of these and you can't go wrong. This is beautiful. RCA Victor, some of them, Nonsuch Records. Cesaria Evora, highly recommended, highly recommended. Did I say that again? Highly recommended. Going into a little more rock vein for a moment, Super Furry Animals. One of a couple records they did all in Welsh. They're a band from Wales, and they put this together out. Pronounce that, I'll give you a dollar. No, I know, I got some people watching here from Wales. But great record, I love the Super Furry Animals. I saw them 3 times when they came by San Francisco. Very artsy, psychedelic pop, electronic music. Phantom Power and Rings Around the World are my two favorite of their records, amazing records. But this record, all sung in Welsh, is beautiful. You know, you can't not include something foreign, including Serge Gainsbourg. Soundtrack he did from Pacha. and this History to Melody Nelson, this influenced Beck, and he actually steals or takes orchestration from this for, I think it's one of his Moody records. It's just, I think Paper Sun or Paper Moon, the song he uses is from. But I just love Serge Gainsbourg and the whole French thing. And that brings me to the Yee-Yee, French Yee-Yee. I mean, I could bring so many artists, but Jane Birkin and the like, but I've showed her before, but I have a whole collection of Francois Hardy. Francois Hardy, early 60s, French ingenue pop, became a pop thing, then became more folky, and hooked up production-wise with Serge Gainsbourg in the early 70s. She became iconic model pop, very French icon. The Yee Yee movement, Y-E-Y-E. Brigitte Bardot did a great version did a song with Serge Gainsbourg in the 70s, late 60s, 70s of Bonnie and Clyde. But love this stuff. Obviously, it's all in French. What do you expect from a French artist? One of the other great albums by Los Lobos in Spanish is this one. And I can't even pronounce it here. La Pistola El Corazón. La Pistola El Corazón, I did. Beautiful record, all sung all in Spanish. So they really mix this in, and again, as I say, I can't stress enough how great Los Lobos is. And since I'm talking Spanish, she surprised the label against the label's wishes, and Linda Ronstadt did this great album, Canciones de mi Padre, from my father, Songs of My Father. Great all Spanish language album that became a huge, huge hit despite the naysayers at Warner album, Warner Brothers Records. Beautiful record. You can find this cheap in the bins now, I think, but I think everyone should get it. It's got just a great feel. I've shown this many times. Dave, Local Bandography, turned me on to it. It was probably one of my top two favorite albums of last year. And it's Enrique Montefusco from Spain, all Spanish-speaking records. I posted something, he's following me on Instagram, which is kind of cool, I thought. He was in some punk band. I still haven't heard the band, so I need to kind of search the band he used to be in. Gorgeous record. Pop, not rock and roll, not dark, very uplifting, but just gorgeous production. Makes you feel good. So I love this record. And lastly, I'm going to end up with this great record from Plastic Bertrand from the 70s. What year was this come out? 1977. C'est plat pour moi, one of the great kind of punky, loud, dirgy songs, and it made the FM charts here. I don't know if it actually hit the American pop charts, but it's played quite a bit on the charts here. It's a promo copy that I got in 1977 from my buddies at Warner Brothers. C'est plat pour moi, great, great, great song. So, adios amigos y amigas. Mi corazón, mi amor. I can't even talk. I know words. I can't conjugate the sentences and use the right verbs and adjectives. So, Mazzy loves you. And come on, it's a small world after all. Let's love one another and all that other bullshit. But seriously, enjoy the music. Ain't all about just us English-speaking people. Mazzy loves you. Take care.